Thank you for tuning in. Today I am going to read a story, and it's a great story, so stick through to the end. If you would like affordable coaching, if you want to have more success on your self-discipline, healthy habits, being productive, inner peace, all those things, feel free just to send me an email message. Email's down there. First session, the consultation is free. The first session is $5, and it really makes a world of difference to have someone to support and encourage you on your life's goals and dreams. One of the things I see in coaching is we're always trying to get to the finish line. Everyone's trying to get to the destination. If someone is going through university, all they're focused on, or the primary focus, is getting that degree, whether that degree is the master's, their doctorate, their bachelor's. And if we're in high school, we're just waiting until we're 18 and we're going to be adults and we can vote and we could be free and have our independence. And then when it's 18, that's not good enough. We want to be 21, because 21, you can drink in the United States. And that's what our focus on. And then when we're 21, we're like, oh, I'm not happy 21. I want to be married, or I want to get a good job. When I get a good job, then I'll be happy. And then that becomes our focus. And we keep on putting off our present contentment for what we believe will be our future satisfaction. And then after we're get the good job or get married, then it's have kids. And then you have kids and you realize how much work and effort and what a challenge that is. Then it's when the kids are old enough to go away and we can have that house back to ourselves. And then when you have that, then it's when I retire. When I retire, then I'll be happy. And then I can go travel the world. I don't have to worry about a job and stress and bosses. And we're forever putting off our happiness. And one of the great quotes from The Office is, I think it was the last episode, Andrew Bernard, he says, you know, I wish during the best of times that someone would have let us know that, or let me know that these were the best of times. Because when they're gone, it's too late. And that's what life is. Life is, now is the best of times. And I know a lot of people are struggling, going through hardship. Part of the beautiful thing about being a human being is the hardship, is the challenge, because that's what it means to be human. That, to me, is a purpose of life, is that we're growing. If you're not growing, you're dying. And we always want to be growing and evolving. And you can't grow without those struggles or challenges. You learn the most and you make your most progress in life through failure, through rejection, making mistakes. That's how you grow. And that's where our target should be, is life is happening to me now. And especially people that are younger, it's always when I move out, it's always something else. It's not even younger people, it's all of us. We have this tendency to think something in the future will bring us peace and happiness, and we just miss out on the richness of life that we have now. And just changing the perspective, we focus so much on changing our situation or our circumstance, just changing your attitude and your mindset, that's what makes the world of difference. And you can have so much joy right here, right now. And even if you're going through struggles, we all go through struggles, we all go through tremendous challenges. And it's the attitude and the mindset you bring to those challenges that makes the world of difference. Okay, so I'm going to read you a story. This story is by William Bennett from the Book of Virtues, and it's called The Magic Thread. And it talks about, it's a French tale of a boy named Peter who was strong and able, but yet sadly flawed by an attitude of impatience. Impatience, we want it now. Always dissatisfied with his present condition, Peter spends his life daydreaming about the future. One day, while wandering in the forest, Peter meets a strange old woman who gives him a most tantalizing opportunity, the chance to skip the dull, mundane moments of life. She hands Peter a silver ball from which a tiny gold thread protrudes. So he has this ball and this little gold thread that he can pull on. And she tells him, this is your life thread, she explains. Do not touch it, and time will pass normally. But if you wish time to pass more quickly, you have to pull the thread a little way, and an hour will pass like a second. But I warn you, once the thread has been pulled out, it cannot be pushed back in again. The magical thread seems the answer to all of Peter's problems. It is just what he has always wanted. He takes the ball and runs home, so excited. The following day in school, Peter has his first opportunity to put the silver ball to use. The lesson is dragging, and the teacher scolds Peter for not concentrating. Peter fingers the silver ball and gives the thread a slight tug. Suddenly, the teacher dismisses the class, and Peter is free to leave school. He is overjoyed. How easy his life will be. From this moment, Peter begins to pull the thread a little every day. So every time Peter feels uncomfortable or doesn't like something or he's impatient, he just gently pulls the thread and then time passes. But soon Peter begins to use the magic thread to rush through larger portions of his life. Why waste time pulling the thread just a little every day when he could pull it hard and complete school altogether? He does so and finds himself out of school and apprenticed in a trade. Peter uses the same technique to rush through his engagement with his sweetheart. He cannot bear to wait months to marry her, so he uses the gold thread to hasten the arrival of the wedding day. Peter continues to pattern throughout his life when hard, trying times come. He escapes with the magic little thread. But sadly, when he comes to the end of his life, Peter realizes the emptiness of such an existence. By allowing impatience and discomfort to rule him, Peter has robbed himself of life's riches, moments, and memories. With only the grave to look forward to, he deeply regrets ever having used the magic thread. Thanks again for tuning in. Comments are welcome. And if you'd like to get some affordable coaching, send me an email. Until next time.